Right now, I'm going to show you how to spice up your computing life. Cue the saxophone. Microsoft has released a bunch of new toys to make Windows that little bit more easy to work with. I'm talking about Microsoft PowerToys.
If you don't have PowerToys installed, just launch the Microsoft Store, search PowerToys in the search bar, and then hit the install button. Once PowerToys has installed itself, it'll be in the start menu right at the top as a recently installed app. If it's not there, you can always just search for it. Opening up PowerToys, we start in the general settings menu. There's nothing much to do here except to make sure Run at Startup is switched on. Down the left-hand column, you'll see each of the different toys. This is where you go to activate and configure each toy. The first one is Always On Top. This one is great for keeping one window on top of all the others, like if you're using the calculator to crunch numbers from a different window. You'll see that it's already enabled for us right here. To activate Always On Top, the default key combination is Windows or Start, Control, and T together. If you don't like that key combo, you can just click the pencil to change it. Now, if we open Calculator, for example, we'll have a look at how Always On Top works. Press the shortcut keys, that's Windows, Control, and T, while Calculator is active, and you'll see that a thick colored border appears around it. Now you can open up other apps and work in those, but Calculator will still stay on top. To switch Always On Top off again, just hit the same key combo while you're in Calculator. You'll see the border disappear again. Aside from the key combo, you can tweak a few other settings for Always On Top as well. You can change the color and thickness of the border, and I've set mine to green. You can always also switch off the sound that plays when you activate Always On Top, and you can exclude apps that you don't want to ever pin on top. The next toy we'll look at is called Awake. This one is simply a quick and easy way to stop your computer from going to sleep without having to mess around with power plans. When Enable Awake is on, the selection you make in mode will decide if your computer will actually go to sleep. Right now, the mode is set to keep using the selected power plan, meaning that if the power plan says my computer will go to sleep after 5 minutes of not being used, then that's what will happen. If I change the mode to keep awake indefinitely, PowerToys will keep the computer awake until you switch Enable Awake off. If you set the computer to do something that takes a while, like rendering a video or uploading a large file to the internet, your computer will not go to sleep in the middle of the job. The third mode is Keep Awake Temporarily. Selecting that, you get another setting where you tell PowerToys how long you want to override the power plan for and keep the computer awake. So if you set it to 2 hours, then after that period of time has passed, PowerToys will stop overriding the power plan and it'll start going to sleep again as normal. The last setting here is whether you want to keep the screen on. If you toggle Keep Screen On to on, then the screen will stay on when you're not using the computer. The next toy is one of my favorites. Let's check out Color Picker. It's active right out of the gate, and the key combo to use for this one is Windows, Shift, and C together. If you don't like that key combo, you can always change it from the pencil button here. The color picker is great for getting the color code for any color anywhere on your screen. This is super useful if you're a designer, photographer, or just anyone who works with colors and design on your computer. By default, color picker will give you a hex color code, which is what web designers normally use for designing websites. You can also grab a bunch of different color formats, all of which will result in the same color. By default, RGB, that's red, green, blue, and HSL, which is hue, saturation, lightness, are also switched on. But you can also get other color formats as well, like CMYK, which is great if you have to do a lot of printing. If we hit Windows, Shift, and C, that activates the color picker. As I hover over different colors, you'll see the hex color code change, and it'll also tell you what that color is called. Once I click on a color, the editor launches. This is where you can grab all those other formats I mentioned earlier. You can also click on the slightly lighter or darker colors on either side here to get the color codes for those instead. And you'll see the editor will remember the last few colors you picked down the side here. With FancyZones, you can create window layouts to help organize multiple windows on your screen. It works by letting you divide the desktop into zones for where your app windows will go. When FancyZones is on, the activation shortcut Windows, Shift and Backtick will launch the layout editor. Backtick is the symbol that looks like a slanting quotation mark next to the number one on English keyboards. You can use the layout editor to select or make your own screen layouts. And by default, you can snap windows to a FancyZone by holding the Shift key down while dragging a window like this. You can also change that behavior and a bunch of other settings in PowerToys. In the File Explorer section, you can set up previews of various file types, either in place of the file icon itself or in a special preview pane. Some of the file formats available here, like Markdown and Python files, might not be for everyone, but I do find especially the PDF preview to be useful. Once you've flicked the toggles on for either the preview pane or icon preview, or both, you can preview the files in Explorer without launching the apps. For anyone working with images and graphics, the Image Resizer is an excellent little toy. Long story short, it lets you resize images with just a couple of mouse clicks. No Photoshop or any other image editing app required. In PowerToys, you set up some predetermined image sizes and then Image Resizer will resize any image you want to fit within those dimensions. The small, medium, large and phone presets should be the default sizes when you install PowerToys. So, for example, if I want to resize a photo to medium size, then it will be no more than 1,366 pixels wide and 768 pixels high. Keep in mind, those are the maximum width and height. So if you have a vertical photo, it will be resized to 768 pixels high, while the width will be less than that. To resize an image, just click and select Resize Pictures. That'll bring up a dialog box where you can select the size you want, and also a few other options like removing metadata, or whether you want to actually increase the image size if it's smaller than the size you wanted. With Keyboard Manager, you can change what your keyboard keys do. This can sometimes be useful if you use shortcuts or if you want to mess with someone's head. I couldn't possibly think why you would want to do this, but to change a key to something else, just click Remap a Key. Then you enter the key you want to change, like D, and what you want to change it to, like an asterisk. And there you go. Hours of fun to be had. I'm going to duck off now. The next PowerToy is an absolute godsend for screen sharing and tutorials like this one. Notice how my mouse pointer lights up when I click a mouse button? That's thanks to Mouse Utilities. Mouse Utilities gives you an easy way to find your mouse pointer, or in the case of screen recordings, a great way to highlight something on the screen. By default, you just click the left CTRL or Control button twice on your keyboard, and that'll dim the screen except for a circle around the pointer. Mouse Highlighter will highlight mouse clicks. The default shortcut to turn that on is Windows, Shift and H. With that on, your cursor will light up whenever you click a mouse button, which is heaps useful when you record tech tutorials like this one. The last little tool in this section is mouse pointer crosshairs. Control, Alt and P will turn that on, and it puts your cursor in the center of crosshairs that follow the cursor around the screen. You can tweak the look and behavior of all these mouse tools by clicking Appearance and Behavior. So for example, you can change the color of your mouse button clicks here. If you rename files all the time, then PowerRename will quite possibly be your new best friend. To put it simply, it's a search and replace tool where you can rename a bunch of files by searching for and replacing words or characters in the file name. It goes way beyond that though, but here's an example. I'm going to rename these files, so I highlight them, then right-click and select Power Rename. In the window, I can put in the keyword I want to replace, for example, IMG, and then what I want to replace it with, like image. You can see on the right here what the resulting file name will be. You can also use regex, I think, or maybe regex, to turbocharge your file renaming. If you want to try it out, tick the Use Regular Expressions checkbox and then use regex operators to control the renaming. You can click the info bubble here to see all of the regex operators, but here's a quick and really useful one for you. the caret character is regex for starting with. So if I simply put a caret in the search for field, then whatever I put in replace with here will be added to the start of the file name. And that, my friends, is really handy. PowerToys Run is a quick launcher that will let you run apps and a bunch of different commands from a simple text field. When it's enabled, the default keyboard shortcut to launch PowerToys Run is Alt and Space. From here, type in the app you want to run, like Chrome, or you can do some math, like 3 plus 3 equals 6. There's a bunch of other functionality too, like the unit converter, which lets you convert, for example, feet to meters if you're metrically challenged. By default, you have to type in %% to use the unit converter, but you can tweak how that and the other plugins work by expanding the plugin like this. So if I don't want to have to type the percentage signs, then I can just tick the include in global result box. And the next time I need to convert a unit, I can just type away and the result will show up below. Now, Windows contains a lot of useful shortcuts that hardly anybody uses, but fear not, because PowerToys shortcut guide gives you a list of useful Windows keyboard shortcuts with the help of another keyboard shortcut. The one shortcut to rule them all is Windows Shift and Forward Slash. You might just have to put that on a post-it note somewhere. All of the shortcuts you see here work in combination with the Windows or Start key on your keyboard. Windows and L, for example, is a quick way to lock your computer so that nobody can send interesting emails from your work device while you're hanging out at the water cooler. Finally, here's a very useful tool now that we all use multiple online meeting apps with different shortcuts for muting your camera or microphone. Video conference mute gives you a system-wide keyboard combo for killing the microphone and camera quickly. So if we switch this on, then next time you're on a Zoom call or in a Teams meeting, just hit Windows, Shift and A to turn off your microphone, because A for audio, I guess. You can see the other shortcuts here as well, and you can tweak the keyboard shortcuts via the pencil buttons here. Before you go ahead and try this out, make sure to select your microphone and camera in the settings below here so that PowerToys knows which device to mute. So there you have it, 12 really useful little toys to spice up your computing life. Did you try out PowerToys recently? Let me know what your favorite tool is in the comments below, and if you like this tutorial, help me out by hitting the subscribe button, please.